I'm Sebastian St. James. Are the S&P 500 and Bitcoin correlated? Should you invest in the S&P 500 or should you invest in Bitcoin? Or are you statistically better off investing in both? And can you use Bitcoin as an insurance policy against dips in the S&P 500? I'll let you know. I've done original research on this to discover the answer. This answer is unique and you'll only find it here. Bitcoin fell below the psychologically important threshold of $20,000 on Saturday for the first time since late 2020 in a fresh sign that the sell-off in cryptocurrencies is deepening. The S&P 500 year-to-date is down 23.1%. What are we going to do about this crisis? Well, traditionally within retirement, let's use that as an example, they have the 60-40 portfolio, 60% shares, 40% bonds. Why? Why do they have this mix? Well, the theory is that bonds and stocks should not be correlated, right? So when your stocks, which is your growth engine, dives, then your bonds should in fact be going up. That's the theory anyway. And therefore, it should smooth out your return over time. And particularly if you're in retirement or approaching retirement, then that sort of smoothing out can be very important. Is that true? Are stocks and bonds actually uncorrelated? Is it a good idea to have both, a mixture of them, or should you have 100% stocks? I've got a video coming out on that shortly, so make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss out. So, some tout the theory of bonds and stocks being uncorrelated. What about Bitcoin? Is Bitcoin and stocks, the S&P 500, correlated or uncorrelated? Let's think about that. And what does correlated mean anyway? Correlated means having a mutual connection. So as the price of A goes up, the price of B goes up as well, and they fall together. They rise and fall, not exactly, but closely in sync over time. Now, that can lead to some problems and some benefits, and I'll tell you about them. Bitcoin and the S&P 500 will either be one of three things. They'll either be correlated, which means they rise and fall together. They will be inversely correlated, which means as one goes up, the other one automatically goes down by the same amount. Or they could be unrelated at all. So one goes up, the other one stays still, for example. Each of these has some benefits and some disadvantages. If they're not correlated, if they're inversely correlated, then they can act as the smoothing, as we've discussed with the alleged stocks and bonds. If they're not correlated at all, then it's not so much a smoothing function, but it does mean you're having assets which won't be affected by the same conditions. So if the market is in crisis for stocks and the market isn't in crisis for Bitcoin, then owning both can make sense, but only if that's true. On the other hand, if they're closely correlated, then, well, why own both? Because if they're both going to fall and rise together, well, pick your favorite one and invest in that. So we know what correlation means, rising and falling in sync. But statistically, correlation is actually measurable between plus one and minus one, with zero being in the middle. So if correlation is perfectly correlated, meaning they rise and fall together, you will get the answer of one. If they're not correlated at all, you'll get zero. Inversely correlated, meaning one goes up, the other one goes down, you'll get minus one. Let's take a few examples. Watching Netflix versus a lightning strike. Correlated or uncorrelated? Hopefully, uncorrelated. If it's correlated in your case, you've got big problems. That would be a correlation of zero. You watching Netflix and you eating snacks. Correlated or uncorrelated? Correlated, let's say a correlation of 0.85. What does that mean? It means, well, mostly you don't eat snacks every time you watch Netflix. Well, maybe you do. But if we say 0.85, it means mostly you do, but not always. You watching Netflix versus you watching YouTube, a correlation of minus one. Why? Well, if you're watching Netflix, then you don't have time at that point in time to watch Netflix. So you're watching one or the other, therefore they are inversely correlated, a correlation of minus one. Let's have a look at the three outcomes for the S&P 500 versus Bitcoin. If the correlation works out to be minus one, that is good. If it works out to be zero, that can be good as well, but one is bad, and we don't want one. I have personally collected all the data from both Bitcoin and the S&P 500 from the 19th of June 2017 right up to the 19th of June 2022. So right up to now, I've got the last 5 years' worth of raw data, and I'm not afraid to use it. Here is the raw data in a spreadsheet. In the second column, we have the S&P 500 closing price, and the Bitcoin is beside that closing price. And as we go down and down and down throughout the different dates through all 5 years, all the raw data is there. There is a slight wrinkle that I've corrected for. The S&P 500, the share market, is only open for 5 days a week. Bitcoin trades 7. So what I've done is I've taken the 5 days from the S&P 500, looked up the dates, the prices for the dates from Bitcoin, and I've matched them on those 5 days a week. So we've sorted that out. Let's plot them beside each other and see if we can figure out whether they're correlated or not. And here is the chart. Oh, in orange we see Bitcoin, in blue we see the S&P 500, but it's just a big thick line down the bottom. That doesn't help me. What has gone wrong? What has failed? The answer is the scale is all off. We've just plotted the data raw. Of course, that doesn't make for good graphing. Fear not, I will fix that. So I've done the data again. This time I've looked at the maximum and the minimum of the S&P 500 throughout that period. The maximum and minimum of Bitcoin throughout that period, that is 0, that is 100%, and we've remapped all the numbers so it falls within that range. Now we're comparing range against range, and so the actual absolute values no longer matter, and we can compare them. Can I show that in graph form? Yes, I can. I've rescaled the numbers, I've plotted them together, and here, let's have a look. Once again, in orange, it is Bitcoin. The S&P 500 is in blue. And you can see, yeah, they are rising and falling. On the right-hand side, they're both going up together. On the left-hand side, they're both meandering fairly flat. From the graph, can I tell exactly how correlated they are? No. Visually, I can see they're fairly correlated. So, what is the correlation between the S&P 500 and Bitcoin? We've got the raw data. We can pop in a spreadsheet function that will actually do the math for us and tell us exactly how correlated they are. Remember, minus one is good, zero is good, one is bad, or anything close to one is bad. The answer of how correlated the S&P 500 versus Bitcoin is 0.913515168197497. In other words, 91%. Oh, Bitcoin and the S&P 500 are highly correlated together. This was the worst possible outcome. Zero was okay, minus one okay. Anything close to one is basically causing us problems, and problems we have. So what we've discovered is that Bitcoin does not perform the function of insurance. So when something goes wrong with the S&P 500, owning Bitcoin does not help. Why? Well, that would be a correlation of minus one. It doesn't have that. Also, owning both assets to give you variety does not help, because that would be a correlation of zero. They'd be uncorrelated, and they are 91% correlated. So why is Bitcoin and the S&P 500 possibly correlated? Why? Well, they both work on the same drivers. They are fear and greed, supply and demand. It's affecting both markets at exactly the same time, largely because you've got the same investor group. No, not all people who invest in shares invest in Bitcoin, but enough of them do, and the fear response and the greed response are triggering both groups at the same time. So if they're not uncorrelated and therefore owning both assets really doesn't make sense, which asset is better? Is Bitcoin better? Is S&P 500? Tell me, which one has performed best over time? Can you give me the data? Yes, I can, in graph form. Year to date, here is the graphs. We have the S&P 500 in red, and in blue, we have Bitcoin, and oh, well, you can see they've both gone down. Bitcoin's in a bit of a crash at minus 70.23%. The S&P 500 is down minus 12.20%. So far, winner, S&P 500. Let's go further. If we take an entire year, we find that Bitcoin has in fact outperformed the S&P 500. 59% for Bitcoin and 5% for the S&P 500. So over 12 months, winner, Bitcoin. Over a two-year period, we find that, well, the S&P 500 has almost flatlined relative to Bitcoin. Bitcoin has rushed all the way up, oh, bit of a dip, basically two camel humps, and then down, 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 93% over a two-year period. That's 93% in total, not 93% annualized. And the S&P 500 has grown a respectable 18% over 2 years, but not as impressive as 93. I can go further, 5 years. Well, Bitcoin has done amazingly well over that period, 593% versus the S&P 500's 50%. So why has Bitcoin outperformed the S&P 500 over this 5 years period? Well, it's novelty. Basically, Bitcoin is the new kid on the block. People have jumped on the hype wagon and followed it all the way up to the top. And now it's crashing and coming all the way down. But that's basically why it's outperformed, just because it's new and it's been hyped. So what can I tell about the future between these two? Well, if we look at the graphs individually, this is what we see. If we look at the S&P 500, we notice that the graph is actually going all the way up to the right. Sure, it's come down a bit, but the trajectory overall seems to be in growth mode. If we look at Bitcoin, on the other hand, it was flat, flat, flat. Massive hype and jump there, bit of a camel's hump, and now it's going down, down, down. That graph alone does not inspire me with confidence. It doesn't have the smoothness. It doesn't have the onward trajectory up that I'm noticing with the S&P 500. So, which is better? Is the S&P 500 better for you, or is Bitcoin? They're not actually the same investment class. One is a currency and one is speculation. The other one is ownership in real companies. And it depends which direction you want to go, which is of course up to you. Did you know that a finance expert once predicted the downfall of Bitcoin? Oh, that was me. Go ahead and watch the video now.